ընդհատ աշխատանքը, որ այս ուղղությամբ տարվում է։ Այս միջոցառումը կազմակերպվել է եւ այս միջոցառումները հնարավոր է եղել նաեւ իրականացնել բյուջետային այլ մարդու իրավունքների բյուջետային աջակցության շրջանակներում, որ կնքված պաստաթուղթը պայմանագիր է եւ այդ ծրագրի համանախագահներն հանդիսանում Հայաստանում եվրոպական պատվիրակության ղեկավարը, արդարադատության նախարարը եւ մարդու իրավունքների պաշտպանը։ Եվ այդ ծրագրի շրջանակներում իրականացում է հատուկ ծրագիր միավորված ազգերի կազմակերպության կողմից եւ եվրոպական միության ֆինանսավորմամբ, եւ այս երկու միջոցառումները, թե հրապարակումը ժողովածուի, թե նաեւ առցանց ավտոմատացված համակարգի ներդրումը, հենց այս ծրագրի շրջանակներում է իրականացում։ Ես այդ առումով ուզում եմ շնորհակալություն հայտնել մեր գործընկերներին, Տիկին Դեսպան եւ Հարգաժան պարոն Շարք, մենք կարևոր նշանակության ձեռքբերում ունենք մարդու իրավունքների պաշտպանության ոլորտում, ես կարող եմ վստահ ասել։ Հարգելի գործընկերներ, այժմ ժամանակը ես խնդիրները ավելի մանրամասն կներկայացնեմ քիչ անց, հիմա խոսքը ողջույնի համար տրամադրեմ Հայաստանի Հանրապետությունում Եվրոպական միության պատվիրակության ղեկավար Դեսպան Տիկին Անդրեա Վիկտորին։ Ուրեմն Տիկին Դեսպան,
thank you so much, excellencies, deputies, Mr. Ombudsman Shombi and Mikhaela. I'm really very honored to welcome you here today on the occasion of the discussion on the new legal instrument of the human rights defenders, especially regarding human rights protection in places of deprivation of liberty. I should say right from the beginning that the European Union has a very good cooperation with the Office of the Ombudsman. We are strongly supporting this institution, which I think is crucial to develop democracy, rule of law, and to support human rights here in Armenia. And I'm very pleased that we have such a good cooperation here. This discussion today is organized within the framework of the EU-funded project Promotion and Protection of Human Rights in Armenia, which is implemented by UNDP in close cooperation with UNFPA and UNICEF. For all of us, it is of crucial importance that the political will and the commitment by all partners are really extremely crucial for the further strengthening of the role and the capacity of the national preventive mechanism in Armenia. The high-level official representation from Armenia today, and I'm happy to see the ministers here, I think shows the political commitment of the Armenian government to further develop, together with the international partners, the situation of human rights in Armenia. Respect for human rights is one of the key priorities in the European Union's external relations. Combating torture and ill treatment is an indispensable part of this work. The actions of the European Union aim both to prevent and eliminate any violation of human dignity and to combat the impunity of those responsible. And if I may add on a very personal note, I can see so much progress in this country since I was here the last time. The right to life, free from torture and inhuman and degrading treatment, is safeguarded by international law, including the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, the European Convention of Human Rights, the Geneva Convention and Statute of the International Criminal Court. The EU attaches great importance to further strengthening human rights in Armenia, including the right to live free from torture and inhuman treatment. The human rights dialogue with the Armenian government establishes clear conditions and principles in this area. We will have the next human rights dialogue somewhat in this spring here in Yerevan, and we will continue to discuss these questions. We reiterate continuously the need to strengthen the capacity of the Armenian judiciary and enhance their knowledge of Article 3, prohibition of torture, of the European Convention for Human Rights. We also stress the importance of efficient investigation of all reports about torture and ill-treatment in all institutions, and the need to ensure that the investigation mechanism is independent and really fully compliant with the international commitments. The European Union's commitment to promoting human rights is also reflected in the landmark agreement on the comprehensive and enhanced partnership between the European Union and Armenia, ratified by the European Parliament on the 4th of July. And in Article 4 of this agreement, both parties are bound to cooperate in ensuring human rights and fundamental freedoms, including, again, the right to be free from torture and ill-treatment. The roadmap we developed together for the agreement implementation presents a concrete action plan with regard to torture prevention and prohibition. Our commitment to human rights is also emphasized through the wide scope support that the European Union provides to Armenia. In particular, the European Union's support to civil society has been significantly increased and supports public accountability and the respect of human rights. And I must say, over the last months, we really saw very promising discussions between the government and civil society really to tackle outstanding issues. The human rights monitoring and reporting by civil society in this area complements the many millions the European Union has been investing in justice and human rights sectors through the budget support, which we will soon kick off, to promote the protection of human rights. Protection from torture through preventive, legal, investigative and enforcement reform is one of the five conditions of the support, together with election reform, child protection, gender equality and anti-discrimination. We acknowledge the efforts made by Armenia in the last years, including through the work of the Human Rights Defender and the National Prevention Mechanism. There are still, like in every situation, there is still room for improvement and further reform of the human rights protection mechanism through expanding the mandate of the relevant institutions, civil society and public monitoring groups, and their capacity building. And we are ready to support Armenia in this direction, and we are also standing ready to support the national authorities in this process through the EU-funded programs. We believe that these programs are coming timely for Armenia. We welcome the success of the measures taken so far and the efforts of the government really to promote democracy, rule of law and human rights in this country, and we will continue to closely cooperate in this direction, and I wish us all an interesting discussion, and I am looking forward to the continuation and extension of our successful cooperation. Thank you.
Շնորհակալություն, Տիկին Դեսպան, խոսքը փոխանցեմ Հարգելի գործընկեր Հայաստանում ՄԱԿ-ի մշտական համակարգող պարոն Շոմբի Շարփին։
Bye, Luis. Dear colleagues, on behalf of the United Nations system and team here in Armenia, it's a great honor to join all of you, Mr. Ombudsperson, Ms. Ambassador Andrea, Michaela, dear colleagues, but all of you in the room here today, the government and parliament, ministers, international community, from the UN system, from the embassies, and all of those of you who are working in this space, the stakeholders, law enforcement officers, judges, and legal persons, civil society representatives. I think this is an incredibly important topic and opportunity, and I think the fact that everybody has made it through the snow here on a very cold morning really speaks to that. I would wish to say that it's always a pleasure, of course, for us to be working in partnership with our EU partners and with the ombuds and the HRDO. I'm reminded of the fantastic anniversary that you had just, towards the end of last year as well, and so many important achievements and accomplishments. In this particular case, the UN Convention against Torture is unique in many ways and brought into the four here, as it is the only exclusive international treaty, the first instrument entrusting national bodies, namely the national preventive mechanisms, with a key role in implementing this international treaty. And as has been mentioned, owing to the specific role of the preventive mechanism, regular visits to detention, places of detention at national and local levels, day-to-day contacts with authorities, intimate knowledge of the context. National preventive mechanisms have really an important role, a central role to play in helping to prevent torture and complementing the work of national and international bodies. But of course, to do so, NPMs need to be fully equipped, both with a strong legislative mandate and also the necessary human and financial resources. And I think that's very much what we are recognizing here today. And of course, I'm pleased to say that the HRDO here in Armenia has demonstrated not only high professional levels and capacities as witnessed in the high-level accreditation, but also an appetite for innovation. And together with our partners, we're very pleased to help bring this together. Has been mentioned, our activities in this role, the UN family, we have three different UN agencies coming together in a joint program, UNDP, UNFPA, and UNICEF. This is all made possible through, we are helping to implement the EU budget support on human rights, as has been mentioned, and we're very privileged and honored to be able to do that. I will not go into the details because I know my colleague Michaela will do that, but just again to reiterate, both, the alignment between the European and Convention on Human Rights and the Universal Declaration on Human Rights, and how these two instruments, which came into being just a few years apart, really are so complementary. And as well, I would just wish to note the link between human rights, fundamental freedoms, and sustainable development, and the achievement, more broadly speaking, of Armenia's long-term aspirations that we see so closely aligned. And I wish to also recognize, to reiterate, as Ambassador has mentioned, that we see really significant significant progress here in the field of human rights, and we're very, very much encouraged and see this movement forward. And of course, definitely, there still remains a lot to be done together, and that is exactly why we are here. So, colleagues, I'll just conclude with a short quote, if I get it right. I think it was Nelson Mandela who once said, "You don't know anything about a country until you've seen the insides of their prisons." And I think this is ultimately the spirit of what we are speaking about here today. Human rights extends, and fundamental dignity extends to every single person in a society, even or especially those within prison or deprived of liberty. So, but this, of course, that end result requires the collective action of so many different people and institutions. Of course it's the police, but not just. And of course it's the ministries, not just. It's the, again, the investigators, it's the parliament, it's civil society, it's all of the different actors that are playing a role, and we very much appreciate the strong engagement of all of you here in today, but in the longer process, of course. So let me just recommit on behalf of the UN family that we stand very much behind working with our partners, with you and with others, very much behind you, Armenian society and Armenian governments, in making sure that this very noble undertaking is fulfilled to the greatest possible extent. Thank you very much. Shnorhakalutyun.
Շնորհակալություն, պարոն Շարփ։ Տիկինդեսպան, հարգարժան պարոն Շարփ, շնորհակալություն ենք կարևոր շեշտադրումները, որ դուք արեցիք, թե քաղաքացիական հասարակության, թե մարդու իրավունքների պաշտպանի դերի, պետության հետ պետական մարմինների հետ համագործակցության առումով, եւ այն շեշտադրումը, որ վերաբերում էր նաեւ մարդու իրավունքների պաշտպանի հետ համագործակցությանը, խոշտանգումների կանխարգելման այդ բացարձակ արգելքի լիարժեք իրացման տեսանկյունից։ Ընկերներ, եւ խոսքը հիմա փոխանցում եմ Հայաստանում ՄԱԿ-ի զարգացման ծրագրի մշտական ներկայացուցիչի տեղակալ Տիկին Միխայելա Ստոյկովսկային։
Good morning, everybody. Dear Madam Ambassador, Mr. Tatoyan, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great privilege to sit in this panel here. As it was already mentioned, this event is organized within the frame of the project funded by the EU promotion of and protection of human rights in Armenia, whereas we work together with UNFPA and UNICEF on several pillars that relate to human rights affairs towards prevention and promotion of human rights, and those are human rights monitoring and evaluation, non-discrimination, gender equality, and child rights. It was very, I think, comprehensively spoken of what is the complexity and the importance of these mechanisms. I would just like to re-emphasize and to summarize several important elements of the national preventative mechanisms that this project is looking at in terms of outputs. And one is facilitating the work and interaction of the national preventative mechanism with the state and non-state actors and the individuals. And in that regard, it's a really, really great pleasure, and it was already mentioned, very encouraging to see a room full of different actors, not only ministries at very high level with a minister's representation, but also different agencies, prosecutor office, special investigative services, civil society, but also academia. These are complex problems, and complex problems require complex solutions and partnerships. And this is definitely one of the most important messages I think we can take away from this work. Then the second pillar, or the second output, is about raising public awareness of the national protective mechanisms at various levels. And this event is definitely one of the core events that is aiming to contribute towards that dialogue, and we can only hope that what will happen today here, the conversation that will proceed, will be a teaser for further interest and for further engagement in this field beyond this project as well. And the third pillar, or the third output, supporting the dialogue with respective stakeholders to strategically and effectively implement its mandate, including the follow-up of recommendations. And the follow-up of recommendations, I guess, is the key word in this context, as it was also discussed in certain ways during your anniversary conference, Mr. Tatoyan. it follow-up and mitigation of the findings, dealing with the findings is always the biggest challenge. What happens with what we observe and what we find? What is the institutional capacity and willingness and collaboration to deal with those findings? So to unpack all these issues, just a brief walk through the today's focus areas. So one of the aspects that will be presented today will be international best or good experience on follow-up of these recommendations, as I already mentioned, based on a report on a study that's compiled by the Association of Prevention of Torture in the framework of the project that we are supporting. And this study is an attempt to really analyze and discuss how the this mechanism can really plan and strategize their work accordingly, the ways they can conduct preventative visits in these institutions, how they do reporting most effectively, and how to do the recommendation and drafting process, and of course with the aim to have effective follow-up. We all spoke about partnerships and collaboration, so one instrument that will be introduced today, it was already mentioned by the by Mr. Tatoyan, is the chatbot. We spoke about innovation, so this is a small innovation initiatives, which is a Facebook-based platform that gathers, that shares information around the work of the NPM and also gathers information and inputs. It was already mentioned by Mr. Tatoyan that I think around 300 entries have been already active in this platform. And last but not least, what we will unpack today is the national NPM, or the National Preventative Mechanism legal standards, as a guide for the respective stakeholders on international and national standards. There was a very comprehensive review of the international legal framework around this issue. I would just like to make a small emphasis on the optional protocol of the Convention Against Torture that really unpacks the issues that the resident coordinator was mentioning: independence, resources, multidisciplinarity, and access. And I would just also like to make a small footnote that resources are very much relevant for independence as well. So these are very mutually interlinked issues. It was already mentioned by Madam Ambassador that we have something to really celebrate or to reflect on, the National Human Rights Strategy and Action Plan that were adopted. But I would also like to mention the important amendments of the law on police that envisioned audiovisual recordings in terms of investigation processes, and the 10 pilot police stations where these audiovisual recordings are being implemented. So practical steps forward. So without further ado, I would like us to all have a very engaging and productive day, and hopefully go with many important takeaways that would encourage us to invest in this work further, as it is always a work in progress. And just to briefly reflect on what the resident coordinator mentioned around the SDGs. So this conversation is part of the Sustainable Development Goal 16, which works, it looks at governance and peace and issues like that. And in our UN circles, we call this SDG the enabler, which is a very important notion that I would like to wrap up my intervention with. Meaning, enabler, meaning that without achieving issues that are covered by this SDG, the assumptions that the other sustainable development goals will be achieved can be put under question mark. So that means enabling all the other development priorities to be sustainably achieved. So on that note, I would like us to go away with considering not only the relevance of human rights in this particular conversation, but how do these issues really affect the overall development and sustainability of societies. Thank you very much and have a good day.
Շնորհակալություն, Տիկին Ստոյկովսկա։ Ես ուզում եմ հատուկ նշել, հարգելի գործընկերներ, որ խնդիրների, բավականին շատ խնդիրներ ունեմ ներկայացնելու, ես դրանք կներկայացնեմ 5 րոպե անց, ես առաջարկում եմ 5 րոպե մենք ունենանք ընդմիջում, որտեղ լրագրողները հարցեր ունեն։